Hello and welcome back to NHB Retro. As you can see, I'm back out in the garage and I've got the TRS-80 Model 3 taken apart again. And during my last video on this machine, I made some kind of vague references to needing to do something about the disk drives. And let me go into a little bit more detail on that right now. The disk drives that you see in the machine here, one of them is the original. So this is the original Texas Peripherals / Tandon drive that came with the machine. I believe it was in the drive number one, or sorry, drive zero slot, zero and one. And drive one didn't work. In fact, you couldn't even insert a disc into it. And I'll go over to the bench and we'll take a closer look at that drive in just a bit. So what I did is I took a Tandon, regular old Tandon, kind of dirty looking Tandon TM-100-2A. I just set the drive select to zero, plugged it in here, and it seems to work just fine. My plan is to move this drive to the drive one position, take this drive out, and we'll see why these might need to have a little bit more work done on them. In fact, let's just go over to the bench right now, and we'll take a look at the other drive that's already out, and I'll talk a little bit more about what we're going to do to address the issue with the drives. So here we have one of the drives from the TRS-80 Model 3. As you can see, it's a pretty standard-looking Tandon / Shugart drive mechanism. This drive controller board, though, I believe is not standard Tandon. In fact, usually when you see these drives, or often rather, they will have a sticker here that says Texas Peripherals. However, the drive mechanism itself is clearly made by Tandon. And this one and the other drive that came in the TRS-80 that I have, or the Model 3 anyway, you can see that there's an issue here going on. It looks like there's a coating that was applied to this wheel and has degraded with time. And also, you'll see that the belt doesn't feel like it wants to track. It feels like it wants to fall off. And in fact, let me take this off and give this a spin, and you can see what's going on. The well, let's see if we can maybe get it from this angle. Yeah, hopefully you can see that. It's not square with the spindle anymore. This wheel is at an angle, which I would think would do some interesting things to the drive speed as well, but it's certainly going to cause that belt to not track very well. Now, I have tried to get this screw out of here. It looks like someone's been at it before me. I'm not sure what the motivation was for whoever worked on this before, or exactly how this thing got canted, bent, whatever it is. The other drive, like I said, is very similar. It has almost the same fault here, where this isn't tracking correctly. I don't necessarily know how to fix that. I've never encountered that before. So I have a plan B, which is, of course, to replace this drive with a Gotek. So let's take a look at that. And this is the actual Gotek unit that I decided to go with. Comes with a very, very nice faceplate with some pretty convincing looking Radio Shack branding, custom drive sled for mounting in the Model 3. Came with all the mounting hardware and all that stuff. And I got this from a very kind gentleman with that contact information there. If you have a TRS-80 that you're looking to add some stuff to or upgrade the power supply or anything like that, definitely check Jay out. He does some nice work. So yeah, let's get this installed in the machine. Okay, things have progressed. As you can see, I let curiosity get the better of me, and I took apart my other TRS-80 Model 3, which is in much nicer shape, I would say, than the one I have been working on, though that one I have been working on is in pretty good shape too. So over here we have the two drives out of the, we'll call them Model 3A and Model 3B. This is B, so not the one I've been working on, but the other one. And these are the two drives out of the latest Model 3, Model 3B. And then here we have a regular old Tandon TM-100-2. We already took a look at these drives out of the newer of the TRS-80 Model 3s. And these are the ones that exhibit, let's see if this is a good angle here. These are the ones that exhibit this issue where the spindle seems to be bent, and there's obviously some sort of coating cracking off that. And both these drives are the same. Now let's pull out, let's see here. This drive here, I'm not sure I'm getting this right. Yeah, okay, so this drive here has the same controller board, very similar controller board as these other drives, but this is an actual Texas Peripherals labeled drive, and not only that, it's going to be hard to see, in the casting down here, perhaps you can see, it does not say Tandon, it says actual Texas Peripherals. And this drive spindle, boy, this is some gymnastics. This drive spindle is perfectly fine, very flat, and you can see that there is no such coating on it. It's just aluminum, like I would have expected. So that's interesting. Incidentally, this one also has a little bit of archaeology here. Some information about something. Service, I'm guessing. Hard to decode at this point. Anyway, and this was drive zero in TRS-80, the second TRS-80. And here we have the other drive that was in that TRS-80. Now this one is just a straight up Tandon TM-100. It has the mostly normal Tandon controller board. It's missing the drive select jumpers. And maybe some of those are, I wonder if this one of those is selected by default on the bottom. Anyway, and no termination, so normal Tandon TM-100. And in fact, there you go. And it has Tandon in the casting, and says, what does that say? February 25th, 1981. Incidentally, this one, this Texas Peripherals one, also has a very clear date on it. September 13th, 1983. So, interesting. Now this, the Tandon TM-100, hello? Yeah, this Tandon TM-100, I'm not sure if all Tandon TM-100s are like this, but it differs from the TM-100-2, which is a two-headed drive, you know, nominally. They moved the servo controller board to the back, or to the bottom rather, Whereas on a normal IBM standard, the servo controller's on the back. So anyway, I'm not sure exactly what I learned from that, except that the drives are kind of all over the place. And it's interesting that only one of the drives out of all of these is an actual Texas peripherals. Though, as I mentioned, these other ones that have a Tandon shell seem to have the Texas peripheral style controller board, which doesn't have, there is no servo controller board. It's, I assume it's just integrated into the regular old controller board. And thus you have this, some extra connections going here that go down to the motor. Yeah. So anyway, I don't know what all that means. I'm going to continue on with getting this, the Gotek installed, and we will probably, yeah, so the plan is both of these drives will go back into the TRS-80 from whence they came, and this one, I'm going to use this as the second drive for now in my, in the Gotek equipped machine. So let's get on with that. Incidentally, here's the what I believe is a repair sticker from the other drive. And this one has a little bit clearer date. It seems to me to say 9/11/87. So, interesting. Yeah. Incidentally, this is the second TRS-80 Model 3. Here's an interesting little TRS-80 Model 3-ism. Both my machines have this. It sure doesn't look factory, but yeah, they both have it, and they both had service stickers on them, so I don't know. Maybe you guys do. And here we have the Gotek mounted in the TRS-80 Model 3. Now, as you can see, I am using the original cable. However, in my case, this cable was not going to be long enough to allow me to also use the original cable with the second disk drive. The cable was just a little bit too short, so I did have to use this extension cable. It's just a regular 34-pin flat ribbon cable, male to female. And then also into that, I did need to plug an adapter to go to the card edge style of connector to the pin connector that's on the Gotek. So, and that's something you'll need regardless, assuming that you're using the original cable with the card edge connectors. So anyway, let's get this powered up and make sure that it's booting before we go any further. Okay, just trying to decide what the best way to show this is going to be. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just turn on the TRS-80 and watch the boot process. Now I've got it set up, hopefully you can read that, I've got it set up to boot into new DOS 80, which I'm assuming it did. Let's go ahead and zoom back out here. Zoom being a relative term. And indeed, we have booted into new DOS 80. Okay, so that's all working well. Let's go ahead and get the second drive attached and see how that works out for us. And here we have that floppy drive installed as the second drive
on the TRS-80 Model 3. Now, again, this is just a standard Tandon TM-100-2, which does mean that it has two heads, but obviously only one of them is ever getting used. I just have the drive select set to drive one, and no termination resistors. And that seems to work. So, okay, there's one more thing I want to do before I get the case all buttoned up, and that is the contrast wheel here is stuck in place. So I think I'm just going to take the opportunity to take that potentiometer out. I have a replacement one. Let's get that in there. And that should be pretty easy. Let's get it done. And there we have the new potentiometer in place and working. It's a great example of a little side project that can totally derail your larger project. But with that done, we can now finally get this machine, I think, buttoned up and just double check that everything's working. So let's get that done. All right, with that, I think we have the TRS-80 Model 3 wrapped up again. Until next time, we basically got the very nice looking Gotek drive in there, replacing one of the original drives. We switched out the other original drive for this Tandon TM-100-2 that I'm using as the second drive here. And we also replaced the contrast potentiometer, which turned out to be a bigger deal than I thought. I didn't have a 500 ohm potentiometer just lying around in stock. So I ordered one and the shaft was just too short. Otherwise it worked great. And I was lucky enough to get come across an original wiring harness with one of the original potentiometers in it as well. And I do have another machine that has two stuck potentiometers in that one. So I might have to try something more adventuresome there. But anyway, yeah, that's going to wrap it up for this machine for now. Today is new machine day for me, which is always very exciting. So I'm wanting to get this machine finished up, get the video posted so I can get onto that new and exciting machine. Anyway, hopefully you enjoyed this second look at the TRS-80 Model 3 and its various disk drive problems and upgrades. And I will hopefully catch you on the next one.